If this is your intention and if this is your expectation, then you're working against your healing. My name is Carleen and I help you move from chronic pain into the power of yourself and your own body so that you can start living again instead of being lived by your limitations. If that sounds like something you would want, then be sure to subscribe to this channel. And if you are already subscribed, then just hit the little bell button next to the subscribe button so that you get a notification every time when I place a new video. As you have maybe heard, when you want to heal from TMS, you want to let go of all the physical treatments. And so a question that might come up for you then is, can I still continue training? Can I keep going on with my workouts? And that's what I want to talk with you about in this video, because you can absolutely continue training. You can absolutely continue with your workouts. But there is something that you want to keep in mind when doing so. And that is what I want to talk with you about in this video. And then also towards the end of the video, I actually want to share a really good kind of workout that you can do for if you have trouble with feeling your emotions. Because actually, I think almost everybody, probably everybody who has TMS has difficulties with feeling their emotions and feeling their body, having a good connection with their body and feeling how the body feels. A lot of people who have TMS often go over their boundaries with their body, not only with their body, but also with the things that they want to say, of course, and the things that they feel and whatever, but also with their body. They are often high achievers who really ask a lot from their body. And so they don't often really listen to their body, like when their body is saying, okay, this is too much for me, I need a rest right now. We often don't listen. And so I want to, at the end of the video, I want to talk with you about a really good kind of workout that you can do to get more in touch with your body, to start feeling your body better, to start listening better to your body and to start understanding your body better, so that you can also start to feel your emotions better. So that is for later. For now, like I said, I absolutely encourage training. It's really good for everybody. Doesn't matter if you have TMS, yes or no, training or working out. Moving your body is good for everybody because that is what the muscles in our body are made for. They are made to move. They are not made to sit still all the time. They are made to move. So I really always encourage to work out. And so maybe that might be a problem for you right now because you are in pain. But I think there's always something that you can do. Even if it's just brisk walking, it doesn't matter. Anything that you're doing that's keeping your body moving is good. And you just choose your level right now. You choose what you can do right now. There is always something. And the kind of exercise that I'm going to talk to you about at the end of this video, I think that's even the best workout for everybody. Like, you can do that at any level. So it really doesn't matter where you're standing. But the thing that you really want to keep in mind when you are continuing with working out, with training, or if you're even just starting with it, if you've never trained before and you're going to start with it, the thing that you really want to keep in mind is your intention and your expectation. With what kind of intention are you going to do this workout, this training? With what kind of expectation are you doing this training? Because that is making the difference. That is making the difference whether it's actually helping you in the TMS journey of healing or if it's working against you. Because if you are doing this training with the intention of, I'm going to do this workout because it's going to heal my body, because it's going to heal my muscles, and my expectation is that if I keep doing this workout, then I'm going to heal. If this is your intention and if this is your expectation, then you're working against your healing. Because you are just telling your mind in this case that you actually still think that there is physically something wrong with your body. Because why would you otherwise have this expectation and this intention? You wouldn't if you didn't believe that there still is something physically wrong with you. So that is really important. And so if you are doing this workout with the intention of just because you like it, or because you feel like it's good for you, but not just because of the healing, but just because you think it's good for you and you like to grow and improve yourself, And maybe because you have been doing these kind of workouts already before you got this pain, then it's different. And so also the question that you want to ask yourself is, this training that I'm going to do, this workout that I'm going to do, would I also do this if I wasn't in pain? Like, say that you are completely healed, you are pain-free now. Would you do it? If not, then why would you do it now when you are in pain? Because then you are actually doing it because you are in pain. And that is exactly not the intention that we want. That's not the intention that we want for doing this workout, right? Because we're giving off the wrong sign to the mind that way. So you want to ask yourself this question. If you would do it anyway, if you didn't have any pain anymore, if you were completely pain-free, how would your life look like then? Would you be training then? Would you be doing these workouts? If yes, then it's fine. But still, what's your intention with what kind of intention you're doing it, and what your expectations are. But if you would be doing it if you are pain-free as well, then it's totally different, of course. So if you are doing the training with the intention of, I like working out and it's good for me, but not necessarily with the intention of and with the expectation of, oh, this is healing my body and I'm expecting to be healed by doing this, but you're doing it with the intention of, oh, I just like working out and I like to be healthy and I know that working out is healthy for me and I would be doing it anyway, no matter if I had chronic pain, yes or no, I would be doing it anyway, then you are, in this case, by doing this workout, not telling your mind that you still believe that there's physically something wrong. You're not giving off the sign to the mind because you're doing it with a totally different intention. You're doing it with the intention because you like doing it, because you enjoy it, because you know it's good for you, because you like to improve your body and you like to grow as a person. That's why you like to do it, and not because you want to heal, because that's not why you're doing this workout. So your expectation is also changing when you are changing your intention. Your expectation is not anymore, oh, it's gonna heal me. Your expectation is just, oh, my body is just getting healthier because I'm doing something that is healthy, because you probably think that working out is healthy. So you're thinking, oh yeah, I did something healthy for my body, so my body is getting healthier. But you're not expecting it to heal you because you know it's not physical. You have TMS, so you know that there's physically nothing wrong with your body. Whatever your goal is with doing the training, so maybe you're just doing it because you know it's healthy for you, but maybe you're doing it because you want to lose weight, or you're doing it because you want to get stronger. Whatever your goal is, as long as the intention is not that it's going to heal you, it's actually helping you in healing by not thinking that it's going to heal you. So the expectation is not based on healing. The expectation is based on just health and fun, whatever your goal is, whatever your reason is for doing it. So there is a difference between treatment and training. And if you're doing the training for treatment, for healing, if that is your intention and your expectation, then it's actually working against you in the TMS healing, because you're giving off the wrong sign to the mind. And if you're doing the training, for health and for whatever your goal is, then it's not working against you. Then it's not working against your TMS healing, because you're not giving off the wrong sign to the mind. So that is the question you want to ask yourself. What is my intention? Is it treatment or is it training? And what kind of expectations do I have from this training? What are my expectations from doing this? That's what you want to ask yourself. Well, and if your intention is actually for treatment, if that is really your intention, if you find out that you are actually doing it for the treatment, then you might want to learn some more about TMS. You might want to study some more about it, read more books about it, watch more of my videos. And you might want to increase your belief in TMS. You might want to increase your belief in that your physical body is fine. And that way you can also change the intention for why you are doing the workout. That is important if you want to heal on a TMS journey. Now, in the beginning of the video, I said that there is a kind of workout that you can do that helps you more in connecting with your body and learning to understand and feel your body better, and also connect better with your body and understand better what your boundaries are, and how to feel your emotions. You just get a better connection with your whole feeling body. And one of the things I think is really amazing for that is yoga. And then I specifically would say yin yoga. I'm not a very much of an expert on yoga, but I have experience myself with yin yoga, and I noticed that with the yin yoga you really get a better connection with your body, and you really learn to search for what is your boundary in the body. And every pose is being held for a longer period of time, so you can really feel for yourself how the movement is, how the position that you are in, how the position is feeling for you. You have enough time to feel how this position is feeling for you, how it's feeling in your body, what kind of sensations you are feeling in the body. And yeah, that way you can really start to understand your body better, and you can really start to feel what your boundaries are, because that is what you want to do. You want to get into the feeling body. You want to get out of the head. We are always so much in the thinking, but we really want to get into the feeling, because that's what emotions are. They are, it's something that you feel. It's not something that you think. And with the TMS, we are so, people who have TMS, they are so much in their head, and we want to get more in the feeling, more in the body, more in the emotional feeling. And I think that is a really good way to do it, by yin yoga, by really, in a very calm, relaxing way, getting to know your body and your boundaries better, and to start feeling how things feel in your body, and really connecting with your feeling body. And that will really help you with feeling your emotions as well. And this can also release, actually, emotions in your body while you're doing this yin yoga. So I think that's a really good way to do your training. But also, the same thing with the intention of doing it because you think it's healthy, but not with the intention of, oh, this yin yoga is going to heal my body. No, because there is physically nothing wrong with your body. It's not physical. Yes, there are physical symptoms, but there is physically nothing damaged in your body. And so the intention should not be to heal something physically, because there is nothing physically to heal, right? So that's the same for the yin yoga. It doesn't matter what kind of movement or workout or training you are going to do. The intention should not be that you are going to heal something in the physical body. That's the most important, if you want to heal from TMS at least. And also the expectation. The expectation of doing the yin yoga should not be, oh, this yin yoga is going to heal me. No, it's a tool that you can use to get more into contact with your body and with your feeling body, with your emotions, and find out what your boundaries are. So whatever kind of training or workout you want to do, you don't have to do the yin yoga. I'm just giving an example of what might really help you. But even if you want to just do weight training, or you want to do running, or you want to do bike riding, I don't know what you want to do. It doesn't matter. Just do what you like to do. That's the most important. Something that you enjoy doing, something that you really like. So pick something that you like, and then look what you can do at this moment. What is your level at this moment? And just start there. See what you can do. And also, what you maybe have been reading in the TMS books by Dr. John Sarno is that when you are going to do these workouts, yes, it might hurt, because you are hurting now. And so, yeah, the chances that it's hurting when you are working out are there, of course. But you actually just want to get through that. You want to just go through the pain. You want to feel the pain. You want it to let it just be there. You know why it is there. You know that it's not there because there's something physically damaged. So when you are doing a workout and you feel this pain, you know there's nothing that is being damaged. You know that there's physically nothing wrong. You know that you can do these workouts. You know that you can do these exercises without a problem. The mind is just giving you this pain. You know why it's giving you this pain. Because it's trying to distract you. That's all it's trying to do. So when you are feeling this pain, when you are doing a workout, you can go through the pain, but you don't have to like force yourself, of course. You don't have to like really go through really heavy pain. But if it's just a slight pain, you can just go through it and tell yourself that you are safe, that there's physically nothing wrong with yourself, that you are safe, and that it's just emotions that are causing this pain, that you know that it's just emotions that are causing this pain, that the mind is causing this pain, that you know that. You can talk to your brain, tell your brain that you know it, what it is doing. That is what you can do when you feel this pain. So you don't want to feel any fear when you're doing these workouts, because why would you feel any fear if there's physically nothing wrong, right? If you're feeling a fear, then this might be a sign that you still think that there might be a chance that there's physically something wrong with you. And so then you might really want to work more on believing that you're physically fine, because this fear is telling you that you obviously think that there's still something physically wrong, because somebody who believes that their physical body is fine would not fear that they're damaging something when it's painful, right? You know why this pain is there, so there's no need for fear. So you can work out with pain, but don't force yourself. You don't have to go through heavy pain. But if it's just a slight pain, you can just go through it. And just notice where your level is right now, because you might have not trained for a while because you were in pain. So your level will not be very high. So don't force yourself and really listen to what the boundaries are of your body. Start all over again, because you haven't listened to your body for years, maybe never. So you really want to start now with listening to your body. Listen, what is your level right now? What is your strength right now? What can you handle right now? No matter if you have physical pain, yes or no, even if you weren't in physical pain, if you are somebody who's completely pain-free, who doesn't have any pain, and you are going to start training, you never trained before, then you also have a beginner level. You have to start somewhere. So you can also then not expect to be able to do everything, right? And that's the same if you are in pain. You are at a certain level right now, at a beginner's level maybe. So listen to your body that you are this beginner's level, and don't force yourself to go through certain things that you cannot do, because you're only going to get frustrated and angry at yourself. And so that is why I advise the yin yoga, because it helps you with starting to feel how your body feels and starting to understand your body better and starting to understand what your body's boundaries are and where you are standing right now. And that will help you in daily life with everything actually that you're doing. Every physical thing that you're doing, it will help you understand what your body is capable of. And also if you're doing the yin yoga and besides that you're going to do, for example, weight training, then you understand better in the weight training what your body can handle, because you learned it in the yin yoga. So really get to know your body better. But more importantly, be mindful of with what kind of intention and expectation you are doing the training. Because that is important if you want to heal from TMS, right? You don't want to give off the wrong sign to the mind. You want to give off the right sign. You want to give off that you believe that you're physically fine. So that is important that you are mindful of that. So ask yourself that question. Are you doing this for treatment or for training? Are you doing, what are your expectations and what are your intentions of doing this training? That's what you want to ask yourself. But other than that, I can only say, yeah, of course, work out if you want to work out. Just do it. Don't worry. Have no fear. If you do have the fear, you need to work on your belief about TMS. You need to work on your belief about your physical body being fine. There's no need for fear otherwise, right? So that is it for this video. Let me know in the comments down below what you got out of this video. I really like to hear from you. And if you like this video, please like it so that I know that I should make more videos for you. And if you haven't subscribed yet, then do that right now so that you do not miss any of my future videos. I would love to see you in my next video. Have a good day. Bye bye.